Bonjour, I'm Agathe Maurice, I'm the Schools and Family Program Manager at the Institut Français au Ciné-Lumière. We are here today to talk about Calamity, A Childhood of Martha Jane. It's going to be the UK premiere, and it's a film that won the Crystal Award for Best Animation at Annecy Film Festival last year. And we are really lucky today because we have Rémi Chaillet, the director of the film, here with us to tell you a bit more about the film. The film is actually part of Animaction, which is a series that is focusing on French animation, gems like Calamity, for instance. And so we are trying to build bridges as well between French animation and British animation and other countries as well. So bonjour, Rémi.
Bonjour.
The film is about Calamity Jane. We follow actually Martha during the years 1863, if I'm right. Is that
correct? Yeah.
Yeah. And she's with her family. She's a 12-year-old girl, and she's with her family.
She's ten and a half. Yeah.
Okay, 10. And she is going west with her family. So, could you tell us why you decided to make a film about Calamity Jane?
I was looking for a second subject for a second movie because my producer Henri Magalon, after a long way off, told me I'd like to work with you again. So I was looking like that. I had several ideas, but I saw this documentary about the life of Calamity Jane, and they said in this documentary that she had traveled along the Oregon trails. The Oregon Trail with her parents at 10 years old, 10 or 11 years old. So and my imagination was triggered immediately because I was looking for subject about gender, and you had this wonderful woman Calamity Jane that later will dress as with men clothes, that she will enter the saloon when it was completely forbidden, that sort of thing. So it was exactly that sort of subject and character that I was looking for, and because of the Oregon Trail, it's 40 wagons traveling in a very huge landscape, and it's a sort of a village in with wheels. So, and I imagine immediately that her father could have an accident, and she's pushed in the life of boys, and because she has a strong character, she is a strong mind, she refused to give the freedom that she discovered with it. So I thought it was a big potential, and I went to my scriptwriter, Fabrice Scriptwriters with an S, Fabrice de Costil and Sandra Sozello. And asked them if they were interested. We worked a little bit on a 3 or 4 pages, and we went to Henri Magalon and Claire Lacombe, the producer of Maybe Movies, and they say yes, let's go.
Okay.
That's how it starts.
When it started, and how long did it take to make the whole film?
From that point to the end of the movie, it's 5 years.
Even though Calamity is a real personality who existed, your film is a fiction film. So you already said you were inspired by a documentary you saw, but could you tell us which traits of character you decided to keep from what you could find during your research, and which one you decided to create for your film?
Well, it's a fiction because we don't know anything about her childhood, and specifically about that period of time when they went through the Oregon Trail. So we had to invent everything from very few historical traces that she left in at that time. The first trace she left, it's her parents had a trial by their sister and brother, because they lived with the grandfather of Martha Jane, and they probably take some part of the heritage, and so it was not fair, or something like this. And they had a trial, but they didn't went to the trial, so they sent the marshals, and they were gone. So they were not at the farm anymore. So we know exactly when they flee the farm in the Missouri, and 2 years after in Montana we find the family in a bad bad shape because the kids are begging. And yeah, so it was very after a very hard winter. And Virginia City is the place where you had a gold rush. So probably the father took his chance and went to find some gold or something like that. But it was not successful, and so the kids were begging. So it's in between those two milestones, we had to create everything to keep it and to put it on a child level. So we knew that she liked to tell stories and to lie, and she was a liar, and so we kept that. We kept that she liked the military. She was fascinated probably by the uniforms, and she liked the military. She was in love several times with soldiers and that sort of thing. So everything we could find and transfer in the life of Martha Chain when during her childhood, we kept it.
Calamity, just like Sasha. So Sasha was the main character in your previous film, Long Way North, that we actually shown as well in the Ciné Lumière. They are both a really strong and brave girl who can only count on themselves. Could you tell us why you find it interesting to show this kind of really strong characters to young audiences?
Well, the two movies start very differently because the Long Way North, the idea was from the scriptwriter Claire Paoletti, and she asked me to work on her project. So it started a bit differently. She had the original idea. For Calamity Jane, it's my idea to work with her, but I'm very interested to create and to work with alternative models for girls, because I think it's important in our world to show girls that are adventurous. So and I think it's very interesting to allow girls and kids to have that sort of models, but not only princesses or very kind and easy girls.
Salomé Boulven did the voice of Calamity. She, when she did the voice of it, she was 10, so the same.
Yeah.
Calamity. Could you tell us why you chose her and how it was like to work with a child on your film?
Well, she was very impressive because she was young. It was her first experience. She had no experience before of playing with that sort of. That's the situation. So the situation, I have to explain maybe what it is. The situation is that we are in a black room with a screen, but the screen here was empty because we record the voice before making the movie. So it was empty. Sometimes we show the animatic, but it's very, very rare. And we explain the situation where she is, what she is, and she have a little bar, and she have a microphone, and she have to imagine where she is and what she would say and how she would say, and it was 3 days of work, something like that. I think it was 3 days. And it's tiring because she was 10 years old and she's not supposed to work. So it's very how can I say, we are under the surveillance of social services, French social services, that said you have to work only from there to there, only like this. But still, it's work. And so we are not. We have to do it and do it again and do it again. No, it's not exactly what we want. So can you start, but with more whatever in your voice? And can you stop breathing here, but breathing just after this word? That sort of thing. So she have to work like this, and she impressed all of us because she was very professional, very into it, and very very keen of doing it. The best she could, and we were like, wow, she's very especially because she and she's shy. A natural character is it's not at all the one of Martha Jane, and but when she is into it, she's able to say, ah, tête d'amuse, and she has loads of capacity, as a theatrical character.
Okay, brilliant. What other animations or other art forms are actually inspiring you in your work as a film director?
Oh, a lot. I come from drawing and illustration. So it's mainly painting, drawing, illustration. But I discovered lately the cinema, because I was as a child we had no TV at home, and we didn't went to the cinema either. So it was as a teenager and as a young adult that I went to the cinema and started to like it. So it's a late discovery for me. And theater, and but I think that my mind is about comics a lot, comics and illustration and painting, that sort of thing.
Okay. And just to finish it, to wrap up, do you have anything to say to our audience who is about to see your film today?
Well, I have to say, I hope that they will enjoy it. What can I say to them? I think that we still live in a society where girls are not allowed to express themselves as boys. And I think that I'd like this to stop. Like that we allow girls to be as loud as kids, that they can express their anger, that they can be rude as kids can be. So I'd like that we let the freedom that we give to boys to girls too. That's something I'd like to say.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, and
thank you.
I hope to see Calamity Jane everywhere in the screens in the UK soon.
Thank you very much.